Guys, so here we have, we'll call it KPC review part two. Mostly going to be just a shooting video here. We sort of already talked about the differences between the KP3 and the KPC. So we are shooting Falcon Fate out of an old one of those 50 cal, 68 cal hybrid multi cal bumpers that Extreme Rage made forever ago, and then a Zoden Steely. So here and here I like my Hitman mod this way with the beveled edge out. It's a little more comfortable for me after shooting these a few times. Also the way I pump if I rest my fingers on this, it's nice. You'll notice a really nice sound signature firing normally. If you hold the pump forward like I did on my first shot, you get a little bit of that farting sound that these things have kind of always been known for. It's real consistent, real comfortable. Shoots an awful lot like a KP3. It's a little higher pressure from what I understand than a KP3. So you'd think it'd be a little bit louder, maybe a little harder on paint. Maybe kick a little more, but I don't really feel that. It's actually really smooth. And the pumping motion itself is really smooth. Oh, a little bit of a roll out there. It's the only problem with a one-piece, even 685 anymore, this pain is around it. Well, it's clearly smaller than this barrel, but, you know, 685 one-piece is a good stock barrel to include with a gun. But with how little the paint is, especially at my local fields, I'm going to have to change that out. So it's kind of an idiot-proof gun. Idiot-proof, not that any of you are idiots. I just use that term to represent user error. There's no adjustability on this regulator. It's not something you can over-tighten and screw up a reg seat or anything like that with. There's no on-off in the ASA, so, you know, there's no O-rings or anything in there, or pistons that you have to worry about, O-rings go bad on, what have you. There's only one rod to give you issues. It doesn't seem to really affect the smoothness of the pump stroke. This is pretty firm. I was worried there might be a lot of play in it or anything like that, because it's, you know, one versus the two that are on the KP3, but it's good, the dual detents are nice. I don't know the way I hold pumps. The pump handle's a lot different on this. We sort of covered that in the KP3 comparison in the other video, but see the way I hold these is, you know, my fingers kind of wrap around the pump handle. It's actually super comfortable. It's a really nice little gun. So hopefully this gives you a little bit better of an idea as to, you know, what to expect with one of these. Shoots great, looks great. This is the forest green. It's a universal color pretty much everywhere. This is more of like a raw or polished finish. The rest of it's kind of matte. It's really hardly noticeable, and this is an optional piece anyway. It is reversible. I just like this edge facing forward a little bit more, personal preference. Nice single trigger frame. Couple points of lube that you're going to want here. These rods, they were dry when I got the gun. There was some lube on the bolt, but the hammer was pretty dry too. So I just hit all those with some lube, and it is cycling really smooth. So there you go, guys.